One man had everything and looked like he was on his way to heaven, but he never made it. The other man appeared to have nothing, but recommended himself to God, and he ends up being saved. The man who looked so good ends up looking bad, and the man who looked so bad ends up looking good. How can that be? Well, let's take a look. First thing we notice is that Jesus was speaking to people who trusted in themselves, who were confident in their own righteousness. Not only that, but the text says that they despised others. They counted other folk as nothing, nobody. And you have to ask yourself the question, what kind of people do that? Because of their religion, you think you're better than somebody else. Because you think you're better and above than, you know, just because you're a Baptist, you don't have to go sticking up your nose at everybody. You don't have to put down folk who not like you. You see, that was a problem in Jesus' day. And the best of us have to guard against the depreciation of others. Be careful against thinking of yourself more highly than you ought to think. Because if it had not been for the grace of God, I said if it had not been for the grace of God, it would easily be you on the street. Which leads me to this parenthetical comment. Don't think this parable is for somebody else. It's for the person sitting in your seat. You need to ponder the principles of this parable. Jesus says, watch this, two men went up to the temple. They both climbed the holy hill of Zion to the beautiful temple in order to pray. They both go at the same time. And he says, one a Pharisee and the other a publican. There ain't no problem with going to church. Amen. And it doesn't take a genius to figure out the story. The Pharisee is supposed to be the good guy. And the publican is the bad guy. Yeah. Now, I know today if somebody called you a Pharisee, you might be offended if you really knew what a Pharisee was. But in Jesus' day, to be a Pharisee was not an insult at all. Matter of fact, to be a Pharisee, you were among the highest rank of religious folk. Historians tell us that there were not that many Pharisees. Matter of fact, they had a few thousand or so, but not more than that. And so they were a small group who were widely admired for their devotion to the law of God. Now the publicans, on the other hand, they were tax collectors. And they got rich by ripping folk off. When you say publican, words would come to mind like dirty, rotten, no good example. They cheated the common man. They were considered spiritually unclean because they did business with the hated Romans. And so he was no good. He would rob you blind and he would give a little bit to the Romans and keep the rest for himself. And I don't think there was anyone in all Israel that was more hated than a publican. Jesus says that the Pharisee stood and prayed thus with himself. Did y'all see that? He prayed with himself. And he prayed with himself to himself. Yeah. Praying with himself. 34 words to his prayer. You compare his prayer to the publican. The publican's prayer was all 7 words long. Meaning you don't have to pray long, amen, to get God's attention. Now, listen in on how he was informing God about how good he was. Let's tune in quickly, and I need you to understand that everything he says about himself is true. Now, when he says, I thank God that I'm not like other men, true. He wasn't like other men. He had a high standard of morality. When he said, I'm not a crook, he really is not a crook. When he said, I don't commit adultery, he really doesn't commit adultery. He's faithful to his wife. When he says, I fast twice a week, true, the Pharisees fast twice a week, every Monday and Thursday. When he says, I give tithes of all I possess, he was far and above in his giving. He is genuinely a good man. But I need you to notice also in this text, there's five big eyes. He said, I'm not like other men. I'm not a crook. I fast. I give. I possess. Yeah, he didn't ask for nothing. He didn't confess nothing. And guess what? He didn't get nothing. His prayer was all about self-congratulations. And do you know what the smallest package in the world is? The smallest package in the world is a person that's wrapped up in themselves. When I look at this prayer, I'm reminded of the old song that says, oh Lord, it's hard to be humble when you're perfect in every way. Now remember when this Pharisee prayed, people would be standing around and watching. And probably saying to themselves, he's a good fine guy. And they probably gave him an amen or two. He was the kind of guy, he won't live in next door to you. He was a good citizen. He was a law-abiding man, a good religious kind of person. Matter of fact, if he would come here today, we would take him and accept him in this fellowship because he's faithful, he's loyal, and he's giving. We probably would put him right to work immediately because he looks good on the outside. But you can't judge the book. You can't see other people as God sees. We only judge what we see. The Bible says that the man looks on the outward, but the Lord looks on the heart. And the publican, he's standing afar off. He would not even look toward him. He's conscious of his guilt, his shame, and his sorrow. He began to beat on his breast, which signifies grief and anguish. And he says, God, be merciful to me. A sinner. It's a simple prayer. Seven words in the English language. It's short and it's to the point. He doesn't have any adjectives. He doesn't have any personal pronouns. First of all, he prayed to the right person. He said, God. Secondly, he made the right request. Be merciful. And thirdly, he made the right confession to be a sinner. Now, he claims nothing to nothing but the mercy of God. And if the mercy of God can't save him, he has no other hope. The Pharisee is puffed up with merit. The publican is crying for mercy.